So we have some more money that we need to count now. But remember, guys, we're not allowed to use our fingers because fingers are bad. Well, fingers aren't bad, but I mean, like, fingers are useful for many things, like pointing at things or stuff like that. But in this case, we want to avoid using our fingers because it just takes way too long. So we'd rather use skip counting because it's faster. So let's take a look at the pattern here for skip counting by five. So first thing you want to do is figure out where you want to start off in. And since we have $5 bills, makes sense to start at the 5 over here. And let's do that. So we'll start at the 5 here. Count another 5 numbers. So we're skip counting by 5. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you get to 10. Count another 5 numbers. You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Another 5 numbers, you get over here. So continuing the pattern, you can see right away 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, kind of like that. So we get two rows of numbers. Now what's the pattern here? Let's try to make sense of all this. Well, one thing that I notice is this. Look, you got a 5 over here, then you get a 0 over here. Again, I'm looking at just these numbers. Then again, ignoring the first digits on the left here, you get 5 and 0 again. You get basically a whole row of 5s and a whole row of 0s in alternating patterns. 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0. Like that. Okay, so let's put this in writing here. So the pattern was 5, 0, repeating. So 5, 0. It's like a 2-beat. 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0. I'm actually running out of space here. So, in fact, let's bring a little bit of life to this. 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0.
Let's go! Rocks barely down the street with the people way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of speed. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat?
Okay, so I got a little carried away here. I made quite a mess. Let me get rid of all this mess over here. Had a little too much fun with that. Anyways, let's get back on this track here. If we're going to count by fives, this is what I would recommend. First of all, how many bills do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, why are we even counting by ones? Let's count by twos. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. So we're going to make 11 lines and let's stack them. For counting by fives, it's better if you stack them. So we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and I'll put the 11th one over here. And then going back to the pattern, it starts out as a 5 and then goes to a 0. 5, 0. So just write a bunch of 5s and 0s down. Like, seriously, guys, how much easier can that be? 5, 0 all the way across. And then this is our last number here. Now, remember this. The numbers change at the 0. And they always increase. So what we're going to do is, to symbolize that, to show you that, I'm going to make an up arrow over all of these zeros. That means you got to increase the number when you get there. So we start at $5, and then when we get to the up arrow, well, what's beside the $5 first of all? There's nothing there. And what do we mean when we say there's nothing there? We mean there's a zero. There's nothing there. So how do you increase zero? You make it into a 1, like that. And then when you go to the next number, there's no arrow here, so you just leave the 1. And then you get to this one, there is an arrow, so you bump it to a 2. Here, no arrow. So what do? You hold the 2. What do you think you do here? That's right, you put a 3. Aha, you see, you're catching on to this pattern, I hope. It's an amazing pattern. It's very simple to use, and it's fairly straightforward. Keep the 3 here, bump the 3 up to a 4 because you got an arrow here. And the arrows are only on the zeros. And then here you get a 4, you hold on to it, and then you get a 5. And then you get to the last one, you just hold the 5. So you get 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, $55. That's how much money's on the screen over here. Hey, let's throw a $10 bill on this. Let's review some counting by 10. What do you think we're going to do next? Remember the rule for 10? Since there's 10, you keep one number on the edge and you write it down. And then what do? Well, you change this number here, right? Remember everything on the left side changes? So you increase it from a 5 to a 6, and then you get $65. That's if we put an extra $10 here. In the next 4 questions, you're going to be counting by 5's again. So right here, count by 5's. Continuing the pattern we've learned. So let's see what we have here. We have a 5 sitting over here. So when you count by 5's, remember the numbers change from 5 to 0. So this 5 over here will become a 0 and then a 5. And then a 0 and then a 5 and then a 0. And remember, over the zeros, we're going to put little arrows. And that just means we're going to up the number. What number are we going to up or increase? This number, everything to the left of this. So the 6 here, when it reaches the 0, becomes a 7. Now let's do that in yellow. Let's make that 7. And then when you get here, the 7 stays the same. And then it gets to the 0 again. You see the up arrow? So the 7, you got to up it. And then hold it and then up it. So you got these numbers here, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90. The next question, so we have a 0 over here. What's after 0? That's right, 5, and then 0, and then 5, and then 0. So looking at this, what are we going to change then? Everything on the left side of that 0. So that's a 12 here. Oh, by the way, remember the up arrows over the 0? Don't forget those. Those are very important. So we have a 12 over here. The 12 stays. There's no arrow here. But when you get to this number, the 12 becomes a 13. And then 13 stays. And then the 13 turns into a 14 because you got the up arrow. How about the next one? So that's 0. And then 5. And then you get 0, 5. So we'll do that here. And so this number is going to start changing a little bit. So we have 89. Here you write 90, right? Well, I hope you didn't do that. That would be wrong because there's no arrow over this one. Actually, there's no arrow on any of them. Let's write that in here. So we'll put an arrow here, put an arrow here. And so like there's no arrow over this one, so you can't put 90. So here, let's do this again. So you hold the 89. But here changes to 90. And then here you hold the 90, and then here you get the up arrow again, so it becomes 91. And these are your new numbers. Now the most, I guess, difficult one of them all. I kept it to the very end here. So we have a 5, and then what's after 5 is 0, 5, 0, 5. And then let's take a look at what we're going to start changing. Oh, by the way, again, I keep forgetting this. I hope you guys don't forget to put the up arrows. Put them in. They help you. So the 98 becomes 99 because it's an up arrow. And then the 99 stays. And then this is the tricky part. What do you do when you get here? It says up arrow, so we got to up the 99. But what's after 99? That's right, 100. Now look what we have. We have the number 1,000 when we look at it all. And then this 100 stays. And you get 1,005. So what do you do if the question asks you to count by fives backwards? You know what? There is a pattern for this. I won't teach you the pattern. If you want to discover it on your own, then that's fine. But I don't want to confuse you with it. It's a little bit different than the last one. So all I'm going to say for this is if you ever get a question like this, and you will, count on your fingers. I know I said don't count on your fingers before. Count on your fingers in this case. It's probably the best way to do it. Or you can use a number chart. whatever you prefer. So let's count on our fingers in this one. Now, to do this, you have to be really good at counting backwards on your fingers. You know, that otherwise you can't really do this very well. But assuming that you're capable of that, let's do this together. So we have 80 and we're counting backwards. So we're going to have 79, 78, 77, 76, and then 75 is the fifth number. You see? And then counting five again, 74, 73, 72, 71, 70, 69, 68, 67, 66, 65, 64, 63, 62, 61, 60, like that. Try these two on your own. Okay, you should stop the video right now and then check your answer in a moment. Okay, we're back. So you should have done this. 120, 119, 118, 117, 116, 115. And then doing it again. 114, 113, 112, 111, 110, 198, 76, 105, 104, 103, 102, 101, 100. This one, you would have done this. 994, 993, 992, 991, 990. And then 989, 88, 87, 86, 985. And then hopefully you won't even have to count on your fingers after that. You can just count backwards and say, well, 90, 85, 980, and 975. Looking at these numbers over here, you see 75, 80, 85, 90. Looking at the one right above it, you got 0, 5, 10, 15, right? Or going backwards, you know, get in a good practice of counting backwards by 5s. 15, 10, 5, and 0. And the same for this one here.